In this video, we will take a multicolor logo and power trace it and simplify it to one color where it can be used for screen printing, vinyl cutting, or other graphic output. Before we get started, if you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on the Discovery Center. Here you can download a written copy of this tutorial and follow along. Let's get started. Customers looking for artwork to be screen printed, embroidered, or used for signage will usually supply a low-resolution JPEG, but a vector file is always preferred. To resolve this, you can power trace JPEGs and convert them to vector right inside CorelDRAW. Some of the key factors in getting clean, high-quality output with no or little manipulation after power trace are: start with high-resolution image, if at all possible. This will result in a better trace. Avoid texture fills and gradient fills if at all possible. These can be challenging when tracing. Solid colors just trace better. Avoid fine detail because it will result in many objects that once traced and can be difficult to clean up after tracing. Okay, let's get started by clicking File and New to create a new document. We'll choose letter size. The document size is not critical to this project. Click OK. And now let's go retrieve our logo by clicking File, Import, and go get the logo. Click Import. And then when you come in, you can hit Spacebar, and that will land it on the page in the size that it was created. And now let's add a rectangle behind our logo so we can see where the white and what other, if there's any other colors or things like that in the logo. So let's double click our rectangle. What that's gonna do is create a shape the whole size of our page. And now we can come over here and click a color and set it to a color so we can see the white. So now we see there's white on the middle and white on the border. So now we're ready to power trace. So if we select our logo, let's analyze what we got here before we get started. So it's an RGB logo and it's 200 DPI, which is a good resolution for pretty good for tracing. So now we can go up to bitmaps, outline trace, and choose clip art. It will yield a good trace. Let it process to processing here. The top part is your original and the bottom part is your trace. So let's analyze the two to see how close we came. And everything's looking pretty good other than it didn't trace the tiny little line in the banana, but we don't really need that for this, so we're not going to worry about that. Now we're going to look at some of our options down here below, and the remove background option is already turned on, so let's see where these checkerboards are. That's where it already removed the background. And we're going to also tell it to remove that color, background image color, from the entire image. And if we click that, look, the white disappears. So that's good. We got rid of that color, simplifying it down. And we're going to leave these other objects on, options on. And now we're going to jump over to the Colors tab, and we're going to manipulate the colors. If you wanted a full color version of this logo, you could click OK right now, and you have your full color vectorized logo. But we're going to manipulate them all down to one color so it's ready to be a single screen printed image or a single embroidered image as one color. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to merge our black. So let's click on a black, and you can see these diagonal lines. It selects, shows the selected color. Hold Control on your keyboard, and it's going to select the other one, and then click Merge, and merge those two blacks into one. And now the next one is this green outside border. We can make that black and merge it with the black. So let's select it first, and then we can come down here to Edit and make it black. Click down here on your black in your palette. Click OK. Now we can merge again. So if we have that one selected, hold Control and merge that one as well. So there, we're almost there. The colors are disappearing slowly but surely here to what we need. Now we want to merge all three of these colors of the last colors that are left, because we're going to make those show through to the checkerboards. We don't want solid banana, or we don't want a solid black tomato, so we're going to make those be white for first, but we need to merge them first. Let's merge them. And we can edit them to white. And then we can merge it to the white. Hold Control and merge, so select those two whites and click merge. And there's our one color logo. So we're ready to click OK and see what we got. All right, now if we pull it down and we look, and we have our black logo. And if I zoom in for comparison, now we have clean, crisp lines on our vector lines. Let me show you in wireframe quickly. If you go to View and Wireframe, so there's our JPEG that was pixels. You can see the pixels. And now on this is clean, crisp lines that if I go back out of wireframe, we can enlarge our vector logo nice and big, huge as we want. And those lines are still crisp and clean, But if I did that same thing on the JPEG, original JPEG, and you zoom in, you'll see that it's jaggy and it's not clean. But if you zoom in on the part on the vector logo, it's nice and crisp and clean and ready to print for any type of output. Thank you for watching. If you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find the link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on the Discovery Center. Here you can download a written copy of this tutorial and the logo to follow along. You will also find other helpful tutorials on CorelDRAW.